Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video series, we will be discussing Commvault schedule policies. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Income cell browser, expand policies. Click on schedule policies. These are system-created schedules, which are already available and ready for use, that address typical scheduling needs. There are two auto-copy, ox-copy schedules. Two schedules for index. One for the index backup, and the other is for index cache load balancing. Three schedules for de-duplication database, that is, for DDB backup, data verification, and space reclamation. One schedule for backups, and is for all agent types. If needed, these schedule policies can be customized by the administrator. Let's edit, and quickly review what it has. This is a system-created schedule. Schedule type is data protection. Agent type is all agents. If you see the list, all IDATA agents are selected here, so you can add any backup type, that is, file system, database, etc. to this schedule. If you want, then you can edit the list as required. The schedule pattern shows, weekly full backup is on Friday, at 6 p.m., and rest all days, it is incremental backup, scheduled to run at 6 p.m. If you edit the schedule, you see backup options, schedule pattern, and replication options. Clicking Advanced will take you to the Advanced Backup Options window, where you see several tabs. We will discuss each and every option listed here in a separate video. Let's first discuss why a schedule is needed. You can schedule jobs to perform commcell operations on a regular basis without user intervention. When multiple clients or tasks need similar operations scheduled, you can create a schedule policy as a template and attach it to each of these clients and tasks in a commcell. Normally, administrators create separate schedules for different agent types so they can be easily administered. Let's create a few and check what the difference is. To start with, we will create a schedule for file system backups. Right-click on Schedule Policies. Select New Schedule Policy. New Schedule Policy window. General tab. Name the policy as desired. Type lists the various operations for which you can create a schedule. Let's select Data Protection. A data protection schedule policy is a scheduling template for backup operations, which includes both backup and archive operations. Agent type lists the agents for the data protection schedule policy. As we are creating this schedule for file system, under Files, select Protected Files, and these are the agent types whose backup can be scheduled using this schedule policy. In description text box, type in the information about the policy's tasks, cautionary notes, and so on, for future reference. Click Add to add a schedule to this schedule policy. Backup Task Options window. From here, you can select the backup type. Full specifies the job as a full backup, which backs up all the data in the subclients. Incremental specifies the job as an incremental or transaction log backup. The incremental backup type backs up the portion of the data that is new or has changed since the last backup. The log backup type backs up the transaction logs defined in the subclients. Log backup type is supported only for the clients with the Lotus Notes agent or the SAP Max DB agent. Differential specifies the job as a differential backup, which backs up all data that is new or has changed since the last full backup. Synthetic full specifies the job as a synthetic full backup, which creates a full backup from existing backup data for the selected subclient or backup set. This type of backup consolidates the backup data. It does not actually back up data from the client computer. For this schedule, we are selecting backup type as full. Schedule pattern tab. From here we can schedule the job to run either one time or daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, automatic, or continuous. We will discuss about each option in detail in another video. For now, we continue with a weekly pattern. Let's say we want the backup job to start at 6 p.m. As it is showing in hours, we select 18. Backup to run on these days. We want the weekly full backup to run on Saturdays, so uncheck all other days and select only Saturday. We want the backup to repeat every 1 week. If we want a particular day or days in a month that this backup should not run, then we can use the exceptions to set it. We will discuss this in detail later in another video. We do not want the backup to be repeated for every X hour. We will discuss this in detail when we create database backup schedule. Click Options. Advanced Schedule Options window. Range of recurrence. Start date by default shows the creation date, but you can select the date on which you want this schedule to take effect. These options are to set an end boundary for the schedule. Never end is to keep this schedule valid indefinitely, which is default. End by is to set the last date on which this schedule will be effective. After this date, the schedule is deleted within 24 hours. End after is to maintain the schedule until a specified number of jobs run. After the specified number of jobs run, the schedule is deleted within 24 hours. If all of the schedules on a schedule policy are automatically deleted, the schedule policy is also deleted. Time zone allows you to schedule a job by selecting a time zone. If you want the job to run at client machine time zone, then select a time zone from the drop-down list. Click Advanced. Advanced Backup Options window. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will continue discussing the other options and create the file system backup schedule. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.